Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. These are my disclosures. I was asked to speak about what do patients mean by urinary urgency. And I try to take you with me on a journey to that. And I start with the most easiest one. What do physicians mean with urgency? It's because we define it ourselves and we define it as a complaint of a sudden compelling desire to pass urine, which is difficult to defer. But the question is, do we as a physician sense urgency exactly the same as patients, or the other way around? Do patients feel the same thing about urgency as we do? So if you ask to a patient, please explain to me what urgency is, this is what you get. About half of them, they will say exactly the words that you use as a physician, but 32% says it's incomplete bladder emptying. It's passing urine very quickly. It's a burning sensation. It's full bladder pain. And even 20% doesn't even know what it is. So apparently it's something difficult, urgency. And trying to resolve the question what patients mean with it, I'd like to go back to the beginning where we have our knowledge on sensation. And it started nearly 100 years ago with these two guys that did what you could say in modern terms, a systematic introspection focus group session. So they did urodynamics on themselves, and they start discussing between the two of them what they experienced. And they found out that they had three different sensations, but they also found out that on the middle one, on the desire to void, let's call it like that for the moment, that they had some difficulties and they argued. For one, it was a periodic sensation, and for the other one, it was a continuous one. And even then, they already said, well, you can describe it in detail, but it's unusually difficult. And although they already pointed out to us, we believe that it was very easy to do so. So we repeated their experiments in healthy volunteers, and we did urodynamic investigations and asked the volunteers to tell us what they felt. And we got this specific pattern of three different sensations, a first sensation of filling, a first desire to void, and a strong desire to void. Now, if we accept this to be true, and it has been endorsed by the ICS, then it would mean that urgency is something different, that it's a different sensation, it's a pathologic one. And we stick with that for a moment, and we try to fit it into morphologic experiments. And here you can see the recordings of a bladder filling in a mouse. And in the bottom screen, you see bladder pressure increasing, and above you see afferent activity. And what you can see is that as the bladder fills, there's a continuous stream of afferent information going up to the brain, and it's based upon several different patterns of activity, different fiber types, different peripheral nerves, different thresholds. But in the end, what you have is that continuous information goes up to the brain. So how can we fit that with our easy and understanding of perception of bladder filling, our temporary distinct sensations? Well, we should ask ourselves if what patients tell us is exactly what they feel, or if they speak to us and tell us what we know, what we want them to know. Because in this study, they did urodynamics in patients, and they said to the patient, we will fill your bladder, and you may feel three different things. Please tell us when you do so. Not surprisingly, they found the three different sensations. But then they also asked in the same group of patients, well, try to have it now on a visual analog scale. And suddenly, all the participants found that bladder sensations was continuous and not different ones. And you can even go further, and I'd like to draw your attention on the left slide. This is a study from Turkey where they filled the bladder in patients, and they told them that they would experience. And the orange bars or the brown bars, they are the actual filling during urodynamics. The yellow ones, in the yellow ones, they didn't feel the bladder. They didn't fill the bladder. They told the patients, we will fill your bladder, tell us when you feel it. And the bladder stayed empty. And what do you see? That 80% of the patients had a desire to void. So apparently, you can induce sensations in patients, or patients can induce sensation by themselves. I try to explain it with this scheme. This comes from gastroenterological literature, and it's the easiest way between something that happens in an organ. In this case, it was the bowel. You have a stimulus, you have afferent activity that goes up to the brain, and you have a perception. So it would mean, if you put this to the bladder, if the bladder is filled in two individuals, there will be afferent activity going up, and they will feel the same thing. But it's not that simple. Because if you look to bowel pain, this is what happens, and this is how they explain it in pain. What you perceive is determined by the things that you already experienced in your life. It's about cognition, it's about emotion. And you add some experience towards the sensation, so it may well be that the same stimulus in the viscera gives a different sensory experience for different patients based upon what they already experience in their life, what they expect about their emotion, their cognition. So I want you to keep this in mind when we go further. But first, I'd like to go back to the healthy volunteers, because I told you that we may have induced things on them. So what we did earlier on was we tried to eliminate every kind of words in our healthy volunteers. We just asked them, describe what you feel in the bladder. And we didn't get the different sensations that we had in the beginning. Some of them said, well, it's a desire to vomit, but you can read what others said. It was a tense sensation. Others call it heavy feeling, nagging, throbbing, pulsating. So you actually had different words in different healthy volunteers. What we then did, we asked them if they could come in discussion between them, if they could limit the number of words, and they said, well, I can agree that it's pressure, tense, being full, and tingling. So these are the words that healthy volunteers use to describe what they feel inside the bladder. And then we also asked them, how do you think bladder sensation develops from empty to an absolute need to go to the toilet? And these are the words that they used. I don't feel anything. I'm aware. It's a weak awareness. It's stronger awareness. And then it changed to desire, weak desire, stronger desire, up to an absolute need. So instead of having these three different distinct sensations, they, if you ask them to describe it for themselves, they had a whole pattern. And if you try to map it, this is what you got. On the left side, you see two different healthy volunteers, and we gave them a water loading protocol, so they drank a lot, and they needed to tell us or to mark on a map what they felt. And the upper left, he shows, well, I feel two things. In the beginning, I feel a little tingling. And then it's pressure that increases, and at the end, it's both pressure and tingling. While the other volunteer on the left corner below, he didn't feel anything, and it started with tingling. At a certain point, it was tingling and pressure, and then the tingling went away, and it was only pressure. The reason why I point this to you is to let you show that healthy volunteers can experience bladder filling differently. On the right side, you see where they map their sensation, and also here you see the differences, because the upper right, it started in the abdomen, and as the bladder filled, it went down to the genitalia. And in another one, it started at the genitalia, and if the bladder became full and the absolute need came, it went up. So again, in this point, healthy volunteers appear to perceive sensation differently. Now, why do I tell you all this about healthy volunteers while we were asked to speak about urgency? Well, based upon what we found in healthy volunteers, we should ask ourselves, is urgency the same for everyone? And if we look to the character of the sensation, and this is a very nice study by Jerry Blavis, he found that if you ask that to the patient, well, some of them tell you it's an intensification of a normal desire to vomit, while others says, well, they are clearly distinct sensations. So again, different patients, urgency, different perception, different character. We also did a study about the suddenness. And here you can see systometric volume. And on the y-axis, you see what we at that time called warning sensations, moments where you perceive something in your bladder, going from zero, nothing, to four, absolute need. And the green line represents somebody who has, between nothing and absolute need, has two other sensations or two other awarenesses or perceptions, call it like you want, before there was an absolute need. While the red one is somebody that didn't feel anything and bam, absolute need. So apparently also in patients, there is a difference in the suddenness of the sensation. And then finally, we also look, or there was also look to the location of the sensation. And on the left upper part, you see where normal people and people with stress incontinence, women with stress incontinence, they point urgency, desire to vote at that spot. While patients with OAB, they map it much more lower and also in the vaginal area. And on the bottom side, you can see the same thing in a different study, that patients with detrusor overactivity, they point much more to a lower side. Important for me in this slide is that if you look to the DOA patients, the ones that have detrusor overactivity, well, they are not all feeling it in the same position. Again, there are different groups based upon where they feel it. So if we speak about urgency and we ask what does it mean for patients, well, if you look at what we presented, apparently it may mean different things to different patients. So is it the same for everybody? Well, this is a very recent study published in Neurourology where they asked to patients with OEB and asymptomatic patients, what words would you use to describe the sensation you feel when you want to go to the toilet to wee? And in the beginning, we say urgency. So what did the participants say? They gave 344 words to tell it. I draw again your attention to this slide. Something happens in the bladder. You have afferent activity, and the way you perceive it may be determined by what you experience in your life, cognition, emotion. And then you look back to all the words. For some, it was sore or pressure or stress. For other, it was frustration, nuisance, embarrassment. So you see how they perceived it, the same thing was completely different. And the authors tried to put it in categories, and you could have language, words to use, intensity of the sensation, weak, strong, absolute need, but also the suddenness, but the unpleasantness, the discomfort, affective responses, anxiety, annoyance. So the sensation of going to the toilet to wee, normal or pathological, appears to be a multidimensional sensory experience. And they also compared these different modalities between OEB and non-OEB patients, and they were clearly different, although there was a big overlap. For example, patients with OEB found that the intensity of the sensation was higher, the unpleasantness was higher, the suddenness was higher, and the difficulty in holding urine was also higher. And then they tried to let them describe, and what they found was that if patients with OEB tried to describe urgency or the need to go to the toilet, it was more a description of urgent, desperate, busting, critical, well, you can read them all, while in non-OEB patients, it was more descriptions of a full bladder. So the modalities, how they experience is different. So in conclusion, they asked me to tell you, what do patients mean by urinary urgency? Well, basically, they appear to mean the same thing as we intend with our definition. It's a sudden, compelling desire, difficult to defer, but it's much more than that. There are other experiences that they have on suddenness, on difficulty to defer, and it may be different for different patients. So if we need to say what they really mean, I think we need to consider also these different modalities, and we should look upon urgency as a multidimensional, in a lot of patients, a negative sensory experience. Thank you very much for your attention.